Welcome to Alanis Business Academy. In this lesson, we're going to walk through how to calculate the internal rate of return. Now, there are several methods of calculating the internal rate of return, or IRR for short. You can use a financial calculator, Microsoft Excel, and even a trial and error approach that we reviewed in episode 127. All of these methods can help you determine the IRR. However, the process and effort needed differs a bit. Now, a couple of months ago, one of our subscribers, Daniel Young, let me in on an even better trial and error approach to solving for IRR. So we're going to walk through that process here, and of course, thanks to Daniel for sharing. If you're familiar with the trial and error approach, the process is very similar, but with a change at the very end. Now, IRR represents the interest rate that reduces the net present value, or NPV, to zero. Let's assume that we want to determine the IRR of a project that requires an initial investment of $10,000 and generates future cash flows of $3,000, $5,000, and $6,000 in years 1, 2, and 3, respectively. We, of course, need to solve for IRR, which is unknown. Using the present value equation, we need to discount our future cash flows to the present time and then subtract the total value of them from our initial investment to determine the net present value. Before we solve for the present value of these cash flows, we need to select an interest rate to discount them by. This is just a guess, and I'm going to use 5%. We've learned about solving for the present value in past lessons, so I'm going to quickly calculate those figures. Discounting each future cash flow by its corresponding number of years, we should receive values of $2,857.14, $4,535.15, and $5,183.03 for years 1 through 3, respectively. Just a quick note is that I rounded these numbers to the nearest hundredth for simplicity, but you can keep them in their original form for improved accuracy. The next step is to add these three cash flows together, which will result in $12,575.32. Then, subtracting that figure from our initial investment of $10,000, we get $2,575.32. Clearly, I was a ways off from determining the correct IRR, but that's okay because we need to complete the process one more time. Since our NPV is so far away from zero, let's select a higher interest rate, say 15%. Discounting each future cash flow by 15% should give us $2,600.70, $3,780.72, and $3,945.10 after rounding as we did before. Next, we'll add these three numbers together to get $10,334.52, and then subtract our initial investment of $10,000 to get $334.52. We're definitely getting close, but we haven't quite reached the IRR. Since an interest rate of 15% produced an NPV of $334.52, we know that the IRR is probably just a little higher than 15%. Now, in our past lesson, we would select another interest rate, say 16%, and go through the calculation again until we reached an NPV of zero. Depending upon how good we are at guessing, we could potentially go through this process another 2 to 5 times before we arrived at a correct answer. Now, I don't know about you, but this sounds incredibly inefficient. So let's walk through a second approach that'll save us some time. We already determined the NPV twice using 5% and 15%, giving us NPVs of $334.52 and $2,575.32, respectively. In our first step, we're going to subtract our lower NPV from our higher NPV. This will give us $2,240.80. Second, we're going to divide this figure by the difference of our two interest rates. Since we're using 5% and 15%, we'll divide by 10, as 15 minus 5 equals 10. This will give us a value of 224.08. If you're curious, this represents how much our NPV rises and falls with a 1% increase or decrease in our interest rate. Our third step is to determine how many percentage points are between the two interest rates we selected. To do this, we divide our higher NPV, which is $2,575.32, by the result of step 2, which is 224.08, giving us 11.49. In our fourth and final step, we add the 11.49% to our lowest interest rate of 5%, which gives us 16.49%. This is our IRR, or at least close to it. If you were to use a financial calculator, you would probably get something like 16.79, with the difference, of course, being that the calculator doesn't round, and of course, I did. So I hope that helps to clarify how to solve for the internal rate of return. If you want to learn more, you can browse our library of over 150 free lessons and download our podcast for free on iTunes. Thanks for watching.